Dwarf Fortress. My name's Matt, and this is my let's play, The Fortress Bannerhelms, which we just started last time, and got to a kind of self-sustaining fortress. So here you've got the main entrance, which I'm going to put up some drawbridges, the farmland, and also kitchens and stills, a couple of early crafts dwarf shops, mason, mechanics and otherwise, and here's the start of some bedrooms as well, which I'm going to extend downwards, which I like to do. It's more efficient, I think. Okay, so I think one thing I meant to do last time but didn't is to start up a rudimentary military with the spare axemen, which I brought with me. So let's just see who that was. So we go to Dwarf Therapist and the Military tab, and it was this guy, the teacher. So he's a teacher, shield user, army user, and axe dwarf. So given that he's going to be a one-man army, is that how you spell McLean? Guy, because he is the wood chopper, we're going to call him Chopper. He can be dragooned into the military if necessary. Okay. Let's see how my workshops are coming along. Well, that one is operating, although nothing's happened yet. I need to allocate someone mechanics, I think. Jewel crafted, that can wait. Masons. Well, it's good to see that my crafts dwarf is doing something. Let's allocate someone with mechanics. The carpenter, woodcrafter, what have you guy. Do I really want to give it to him? Yeah, I suppose there's no other choice, is there? So, there we go. I think I can build some doors now I've got some. There we go. Are all of those beds correctly built? No, they're not. Because of those rocks in the middle of them. I think I might build some more beds actually, because this bit here was meant as a dormitory. Hmm. That's a fine looking great hall. Now, I think I need to allocate some new crafting facilities. I think I'm going to try and put the majority of it all on one level. So I'm going to go down a couple of levels from here. Maybe three levels? I don't know actually. What's the rock? Rhyolite. Marion's. What's this one? Siltstone and schist. Alternately, schist, siltstone. Or sphalerite. I think. Excuse me. I think I've got more chance of striking ore in this one. So we're going to designate some mining levels, and as I'm going to try and get everything all on one level this time for manufacturing purposes, that stockpile stockpiles, it's better to have one step above or below. Well, we'll do as much as we can, so we'll go for quite a long exploratory arrangement. Should give them something to think about, and also I'll just set a hotkey there so I can come back to it easily. There we go. So I've got quite a few animals there, and that's the cornerstone of economy. So I'll need to create some nest boxes. And I think a training area for the dogs as well. I think I might do that. Well, the nest boxes, it makes sense to have those kind of in the same place as the food, so maybe kind of here. Let's make some nest boxes. So we'll go for the Craft Dwarf's workshop. Here he is. And add a task, rock. And there we go, nest boxes. Well, I'll need a few more of those, but I'll come back to add those tasks later. Well, now it looks like all of my bedrooms have been correctly set up. I can designate these as actual bedrooms now. There we go. So that's an individual bedroom for each of the main dwarves. I think I need to build a few more beds as well, thinking about it. That wood furnace still hasn't been built. A and B to add a bed. Because I want quite a few more beds in that dormitory before the migrants arrive. See how the miners are doing. Well, they've hit a few gems, but is that all? Is that just stone? That's just stone, isn't it? Schist and florage. Moss opal and schist. That's just a load of old schist. Maybe I should have gone down deeper. Or not expected so much here. I can't remember now whether it said light shallow metals or deep metals? Never mind. We'll find them. One of the dwarves there correctly using his bedroom. Instead of having bad thoughts by sleeping on the floor. Okay. Let's smooth this stone down. I wonder if I've got a dwarf who can do so. If not, I'll allocate one from the first wave. Now, have I got any beds? I do. Well, allocate that as the dormitory now. So R to make it a bedroom, plus to size it to the whole thing, and enter, and then D to make it a dormitory. There we go. So dwarves who don't have their own bedroom will automatically use that. Short time, we'll be able to allocate some new crafting areas. I wonder how much good would a wooden shield be? They used to use them. In the olden days, anything else was too heavy. Or just layers of skins. Quite a few gems down here, actually. That's not too bad. They've got such a curious way of choosing where to mine. I don't know what the algorithm might be. So curious. That guy's going for a drink. Oh, that reminds me, when was the last time I queued up any tasks? Well, that kitchen's not even been built. That one is preparing meals. That guy's brewing a drink, and that guy is extracting. Is that working? What's the cook doing? So it's you for your units. I think he... Is he... Vabok. Let's see if Vabok is our cook. So, cooking, etc. Yep, Vabok. So he's the cook and the farmer. But he also does a lot of other stuff. Poor guy, probably just worked off his feet. We need more immigrants, that's what we need. Okay. Well, I think I might put a food stockpile. J for a downward stair, and is that the centre? Looks like it. There we go. actually, what I really want to do is remove its current stockpile designation. Just that one bit. There we go. Now, D for designate, J for a downward stair. There we go. And then we'll go down one. And, yeah, just an upward stair. No, first of all, I need to map out the size of it. And then it's in the centre. Was that the centre? Yeah. And then U for an upward stair in the middle. There we go. And that's going to be a stockpile, which will be very conveniently placed to reach from either of those kitchens or stills. Wonder if that mechanics has been built yet. To add a few more nest boxes, really. So rock 6 should be fine. That's one for each female bird I've got right now. And just a couple more pots, I think. I think I'll just put that on repeat, actually, that last one, because you can never have too many rock pots. I get the feeling I'm missing something important. I'm forgetting something. Oh well, that'll probably become apparent when something starts to die. Okay, well, they've hollowed out this big area. And I think the first thing I'm going to do with this is designate some work spaces. That should be fine for the moment. And something so the miners can get in there. There we are. Of course, what those miners are probably doing right now is going for a drink, something to eat. Having just done a massive dig. Oh no, they're coming back. They're just digging something else, whatever else I told them to, which I now don't remember. That. They're working quite quickly now, but as the number of dwarfs grows and the size of the fortress grows, we approach critical slowdown. My processor is not one of the best. It's alright. It was good for gaming a few years back. But now, it's not great. So, P for stockpiles, F for food. Actually, I'll just remove that one little bit to save from storing barrels on my staircase, which I always find annoying. And there we go. Quite pleased with that. The trick is, when avoiding frame rate issues for as long as possible, to make sure there's only one path that dwarves can do from anywhere to anywhere. So, for example, this is fine, but if I were to connect this bit here to give them two possible paths to go through, then they would use more processor time calculating the path to go through than would normally be the case. If they can only go one way, then they will only go that way. So that's one little hint. Another one is to try and cut down on clutter, but that really gets impossible. It's very hard to do. You need to atom smash things. Not really worth it. Seem to be growing things quite successfully. Let's have a quick look at our food stores. So we've got 300, drink is 200 of that. That's quite good. I'm not sure whether I gave anyone the plant gathering label. I think I probably should have done. Turkeys grazers, are poultry grazers? That's the question. I don't want to have to crack the caverns this early. But I suppose I could, and then just wall them off once the spores have escaped. I really need some more dwarfs. When's the first migration wave due? Right. Let's see if building a hall will speed things up. So, 6 tables, and eventually, like 10 chairs. In the meantime, press M for military. Let's set up a squad. So, military commander. Let's press C. And we're going to choose metal uniform because he's an axe man. And the Rough Sparks is the name of the first squad. Well, that's pretty good. And we are going to call McLean our one-man army, John McLean, Die Hard, the Commander-in-Chief. As for his equipment, he should just use the axe by choice. We'll see. So, I think we'll need to set his schedule. So he looks like he's just set to train throughout the year. That's good. Sleeping room at will. Yep, we'll leave that. Inactive equals uniformed. Yep, we'll leave that. Says train 10 minimum. Well, we want just him training, and we don't want him to go too much, so... Oops. There we go. So, every 3 months he gets a month off. Hopefully that way he won't go mad. And he'll be able to use the lavatory in that time as well, which is very important. Let's Some rather large areas have been designated here, so I'm going to build all of the things I built upstairs again. So that's a carpenter's. I'll build that there. In actual fact, I'm going to build a few carpenters. Because people need wooden things. That's one of the main things in life. I really should have designated an up or down stairway in the middle of that. Oh, that's a shame. Never mind, I can bring it on from there. So, let's just build that staircase. B, capital C, and then X for up or down stair. Is that the middle? Yes, it is. There we go. And we'll build that from chest. And then we'll go up a level. Build an up or down stairway on top of it. Or designate one rather. And then designate pull down stairway below it as well. Okay, so the season's changing. Let's have a quick look at Dwarf Therapist. Well, my woodcutter only has that to do. I could really give him something else to do. So wood burning, furnace operating, just in the hope that he might actually build that furnace. So let's commit those changes before I forget. What does this guy do? Enosh, oh, he's a miner. Pretty much got to leave him alone. That's my cook slash peasant. I think we'll call him farmer. Enosh Kanzaz. Well, so I don't keep looking at the miners, I'm just going to go miner. And which one of these has the appraiser skill? Is it that one? Yep. So we're going to call that one master miner. Dwarf, so we'll call him Crafty. Right now, there we go. Okay, so remember to commit those changes. And let's see if Dwarf Fortress is running again. Yes, it is. Wonderful. And now let's designate the storerooms around those. And I think I built carpenters in there. Yeah. now I need to build craft dwarfs. So B, W, and is it R? Yeah, R for a craft dwarfs. I think for stone, oops. Piles, stone, so we're going to have a supply of stone close by to them, but also some wood as well for the carpenters. Above we're going to have more wood stockpile, and down below we're going to have the finished goods and furniture, and that can go down a few levels, because for a dwarf it's just as efficient to go up or down a level as it is to go side by side. So it does make it a lot more efficient to stack those storehouses. Elven caravan. Well, I actually don't have anywhere, so let's build and then capital T. Oh no, is it capital D for a trade depot? There we go. And I probably shouldn't build out of wood if I'm hoping to trade with the owls. So let's build that out of schist. There we go. So it's going to take my dwarves an extra long time to all the stone up there, but that's the way it is. So now we've got somewhere else for our industries. We can get rid of the early ones by pressing X on them, and then I'll also get rid of those stockpiles, P and X, to remove the designation. There we go. Take these back to their original purpose, which is their planned purpose, which is barracks. And I'm going to have my soldiers training there when I finally get some. So I think I should have built some nest boxes by now. So B and then capital N for a next nest box, and let's just put a few of those down here. There we go. So we're going to need to pasture some animals there. Is that N? Capital N? I can't remember. I'm going to have to look. Is it a zone? Is it I? Designate that zone. N. for it to be a pasture, and then capital N to assign animals to it. And we're going to assign the turkeys and the chickens. There we go. And I think next door to that, we're going to have the animal industries. So, B, W, and then U for a butcher's. There we go. And is it L for a leather worker's? Or rather, I need N for a tanner's first. There we go. A leather worker, is that a leather worker I can have elsewhere? Butcher and tanner is fine for the moment. Butchers and the tanners. I'm gonna need a corpse stockpile and refuse stockpile. Yeah, that's something I think I've got. A refuse zone. Probably it's building up. Box, I wonder why. Okay, so P for piles, and then R for refuse, and then what's corpses? So anything nasty will get stored there, and our dwarves won't get bad thoughts, hopefully. Okay. Hopefully those turkeys will start being moved down pretty shortly. There's my food stockpile, the new one. To make a stockpile for finished goods, didn't I? So, G for finished goods. And then, let's just see, for this one here, it was going to be masons and other metal using industries. There we go, so three masons there. And again, I'm going to have to build an up or down staircase. Giant wood stockpile. I want enter there. So I'll designate another up or down stairway above and below. Oh, I forgot to do that again. Same plan again, a stockpile above and a stockpile below. The one above for raw materials and the one below for finished goods. Again, they're telling me they can't complete these nest boxes. Oh, I know why. It's because I deconstructed the building they were in. Somewhere. They just haven't been reassessed. Yep, there we go, diorite nest box. Gneiss nest box. Siltstone nest box. Maybe if I start that whole process again. Why haven't the turkeys been moved down? That's what I want to know. Stone stockpile above. Whoops, almost made it too big. It'll still be there. And then a stone stockpile below as well. Oh yeah. Gotta remove that. And here, right at the bottom, it's going to be a furniture stockpile this time. Drinks, 300 food in general. That seems fine. Have I got anyone who can butcher an animal? Butchery and tanning. Butchery and tanning. Well, butchery, it does make sense to have the cook do it. Yeah, why not? I'll just give him butchery and tanning. There we go. Ah, there we go. Now the nest boxes have been moved into place, and the chickens seem to have been moved in with them as well. Chickens and turkeys, poultry in general. Let's see exactly what's going on here. Well, the kitchen hasn't been made yet. Those easy meals haven't been made yet. I think it's because I put that on repeat. I should have taken those off repeat a long time ago. So, some easy meals coming up. But at least I've got a lot of drink. The dwarves can always eat raw plump helmets, but the drink, that's the important thing. Can't get drunk on water. I tried. Alright, you can. Water intoxication, but it's fatal. So, this trade caravan just never materialised, but that's fine, it was only elves, they would have just got upset. All the wood I've cut down. I really need to build some bridges at some point. Seal myself in. And then some giant walls. Some kind of miasma? Is that flies? Ticks? And snails and ticks and lice. Well, nice to see that the chickens brought in their parasites. Are they going to eat them? I think chickens would eat ticks in real life. Let's hope they do so. Yeah, there's some blood there. Oh, there's not. Okay. P and then U for furniture. And there we go. So we've got one pile for furniture, one for finished goods, and a load of masons, crafts, dwarfs, and carpenters. Now, I'm going to do a similar thing for jewellery. Again, keeping the diagonal exit, which I always do. Even when miasma, you wouldn't think would be an issue. Always best to. And then we want a up and down stairway in the middle of each one. Those elven merchants will be leaving soon. That's a shame. Should maybe send my axe man out to kill them. Okay. Let's remove this carpenter's workshop. That wood furnace still didn't work. We can remove the wagon. I want to see what's inside the wagon first. It's T to look inside something. It's just some bags. Yeah, so we can happily remove that wagon. Okay, we'll leave that there because it might come in handy at some point. And then we'll remove the wood stockpile there. There we go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the guy's cooking meals now, which is good. Gonna add some more tasks for him. Let's cook some lavish meals. There we are. Okay. Now I think we need to do something with our craft dwarfs. So, rock pots, I think. Because that's where you store your food and drink. And if you don't want to use wood for barrels, that's your only choice. I think next we'll have rock crafts. Boxes and some hives just in case there's bees on the map, and I think we'll have some beds. A couple of barrels and a couple of bins. Merchants have embarked. Last chance to kill them. Nah, next time. This is going to be my new barracks. That's taking shape, and I'm going to do the bottom layer as well. Oops, is that right? Yeah, there we are, and I'm going to put in the staircases again. There we go. And this time I think we need gems. gem stockpiles for at least one of them. And they don't take up much space at all. So it's build, W, and then J for a jeweler's. And I'm going to lay down three of those. The Great Hall. Let's see if we can do something about that. Make it a bit more great. So B for build, T for table. Oh, I haven't got any tables yet. Oh, I thought I did. Chairs? Nope. Doors? Nope. Okay, we'll do that later. These miners are going to be experts before long. Why haven't I had any migrants? Still got the original seven dwarves. At this point, they should all be grumpy. First two migrant waves are hard-coded. See if we can do something about these barracks. So R plus to size it, B to make it a barracks, the rough sparks will T train inside it, and Q keep their squad equipment inside it, and that should be sufficient. And then I need to go into squads, so A, and then you can see the rough sparks there. There we go. And select them with A. And then T to toggle them to active. So now this guy should follow his schedule, and that is training in this barracks, 2 months out of three. And the third month he can take off. There we go, you can see McLean has become a militia commander. And maybe next episode I'll use him to kill the fleas, ticks and lice which are infesting my turkey sanctuary. Or maybe not. We'll see. Either way, I think that's enough for this episode, so thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.